Hi, I'm Pastor Goodman.
And this is the Lord's Catechized Life.
So, the Lord's Prayer is one of those places where the liturgy flows out of the divine service and into our lives, that it manages to actually exit the church building proper and kick its way into our own homes and into our own practice, because we ought to be praying this thing every single day. Even as we pray, give us this day our daily bread, this is a prayer that really ought to be on our lips every single day. And it is an important thing that Christians actually do live liturgically. We live inside of what we are taught and what we are given inside of the divine service. And that doesn't mean simply that we just interact only by exchanging the ordinaries of the divine service, like trying to have a conversation exclusively in movie quotes or gifts. It's that how we pray, how we worship, our piety, the rituals that we observe, they all shape what we believe. They reinforce all of these things in a way that goes even deeper than purely that of the intellect. For example, it's really actually hard to have a praise service to God with a gigantic crucifix hanging in your church with, like, dead Jesus glaring down at you while you're so happy. Just saying. But though, in looking at that crucifix, I do see God's love for me, and I do praise him. Not simply rooted in my situation and how good things are going for me or how great I happen to feel, but I praise God that he would bear that situation for me. I praise God that by bearing the cross, I might receive mercy. But we also live liturgically in a way that carries out into our lives. Knowing who I am in my baptism, it lets me look in the mirror, singing the Nunc Dimittis every week after communion. It lets me face my own mortality, because I am going to die, but I will depart in peace. Receiving the Lord's Supper is a strength to carry forward in the knowledge of God's presence and his peace and his mercy and his life. And we are taught to pray the things that remind us both of who we are and who our God is. So when our Lord would teach us to pray, "Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us," Luther in the Large Catechism writes, "This should serve God's purpose of breaking our pride and keeping us humble." In other words, it tunes us into the reality that's going on around us, that whether or not we are praying it, it doesn't change the fact that it's happening. But when we pray, we start to notice it. See, we talk about Christian growth and sanctification, and we try and measure it in really silly things like how often we do the dishes, or even the bigger things like managing to avoid an addiction. But lest we think too much of ourselves, God reminds us that we live hand to mouth. Luther continues, "In short, if God does not forgive without ceasing, we are lost." See, we're sinners. In this body and life, we're always going to be sinners. So much do I realize this that I'm not going to bother measuring my growth and sanctification like a kid just eager to be tall enough to go on the really fun rides at the carnival. Instead, we can acknowledge that God will work as he intends to, but also, I'm a sinner, and so God must constantly forgive me. But he does. You see, when we are taught to pray, "Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us," it's not nearly as much about us as it is about him. This is about his character, his mercy. And God is a gracious giver. He has already forgiven you, and he continues to pour out this gift for you constantly. We are beggars. But this is not about us. This is about Jesus for us. This is about Jesus who gives even to sinners. So we pray, "Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us." And he does. Constantly. The joy is that prayer would remind us of this, that we would live as Christians ought, with our eyes fixed upon the cross.